talking for me. Go ahead and ask her. I don't have to talk. I got her doing it. My job is basically blues singer, but I'm a record producer and a songwriter and a band leader, I guess, all that stuff. That's what I do.
What do you think in the future of blues music will be like in 5, 10 years and so forth?
Oh, it'll be over with, I'm sure. I can't imagine it lasted this long.
Why do you think so?
Oh, well, because it's so low down and depressing and pitiful. Today, people really need something to pick their spirits up, like cartoons. Blues music is, that's such an old, passé, depressing kind of thing. No, actually, I'm sorry, I should do that. Blues is not a sad thing. Blues is the way to celebrate life by saying, here's how bad things really are. I'm not going to cover it up, but I'll fight it and I'll win. I'll get over it. I'm gonna survive because, you know, it's a positive thing.
And how can blues influence people? How does blues influence people?
I don't know. I don't know how to answer that question. I guess like anything, it can either bring people to the realization that there's no hope, or it can bring people to the realization that it's up to them and they have to go do something about it.
What advice would you give the people looking to get into the blues music industry?
Go to school, be a doctor, a lawyer, something, make some money, never mind. That would be my advice to anybody. I started the piano when I was 4 years old, and I sang in the church choir. And at some point, I think I was 16, 1962, I walked out of the church choir and started singing about women for money. And that's all I've ever done. I've had one job for, I'll be 70 years old in a few weeks. So, what do I know?
Great.
I wish I had better answers for you, but I wasn't prepared for any of these questions.
Well, I know.
I'm not into this big philosophical, what do I think doesn't matter.
It does matter to young blues people who are interested. So thank you for taking the time.
Well, if you hear the blues and you love the blues and it moves you, then your obligation to the blues is to study it, respect it, honor it, and not twist it around, make it into something it's not. There's no such thing as blues rock.